Rhinolith is a common short note for both undergraduate and postgraduates, and this is quite common in your clinical practice also. So we can discuss Rhinolith as what is a Rhinolith, how will you diagnose it, and what are the treatment options. So this Rhinolith, in simple term, is a partially or a totally calcified mass of tissue within the nose, and this can be formed around a foreign body in the nose, or it can develop de novo. Okay, so in the nose, if there is a foreign body, there is a foreign body inside, and layers of mucin get collected around this foreign body because of the turbulent air currents in the nose. Layers of mucin get collected around this foreign body, which is later on get deposited with calcium and magnesium salts. So this foreign body becomes a laminated structure. So that is why I already told that it is a partially or a totally calcified mass of tissue within the nose, and this can be around a foreign body nidus, or this can either around a foreign body nidus, or this can develop de novo in the nose. Okay, and there are two types of foreign body rhinolith. One is endogenous and another one is exogenous. Endogenous means there is something inside the nose. What all things can happen? It can be around the blood clot. Or it can be a displaced tooth. So endogenous means around a body structure or body material, and exogenous means once something that has inserted into the nose from outside, like a foreign body. And these foreign bodies can be anything like a peanut or button bat. And how will you diagnose it? Diagnosis is easy because of the typical symptoms and examination findings. And what will be the common symptoms of the patient? Symptoms and sign, that is on examination. There is a mass sitting inside the nose, so the patient will complain of nasal block. Okay, so the commonest symptom will be a nasal block, and also there will be a foul smelling, purulent nasal discharge. If unilateral foul smelling nasal discharge from the nose, you should always think in terms of a foreign body in the nose. Okay, and on examination, you can see a greyish or a brownish mass. The usual site is between the septum and the inferior turbinate. Okay, that is a brownish mass in the nose, commonly between the septum and the inferior turbinate. And if it is very big one, it can lead to, it can press upon the eustachian tube area and causing a ear block and ear pain. Some even this can lead to an ear discharge also. Okay. And if it is big, causing erosion of the surrounding areas, there can be septal perforation of the septum. And if it is pressing on the palate, it can lead to an oroandral fistula. Okay, and these are the and the septal perforation and oroandral fistula, etc., will occur because of erosion, and that will be caused by a large mass. Okay, so these are the symptoms and signs, and in some cases, remember, the patient will be completely asymptomatic also, and this is identified or diagnosed incidentally. Okay, so symptom and examination finding, and sometimes patient will be completely asymptomatic. CT scan also. And the CT scan is needed. So the CT scan is needed in case to confirm, for confirmation of diagnosis, to find out the size of the mass, and also to decide upon the surgical incision or the surgical method if it is a very large mass.
Okay.
Otherwise, a CT scan is not needed. If it is directly, you can find out by doing a diagnostic nasal endoscopy. You can remove it transnasally itself.
Okay.
And the treatment is nothing other than removal. There is a mass, you have to remove it. And this removal can be under the endoscopy guided transnasally, or if it is a very large lesion, you have to go through a lateral rhinotomy approach. Okay. If it is too big, do a lateral rhinotomy approach and remove the mass, and if it is small, do under a transnasal removal using endoscope. Okay. So this is regarding rhinolith.